Hello everyone, Mike Starks with RE/MAX Town & Country here. Today we're looking at 45 Bell Mountain Road, a really awesome 4-bedroom, 4.5-bath house, offering a little over 3,000 square feet, sitting on 14.96 acres. And as you can see, I'm just out in the front yard, giving you the quick 360. Lots of really nice, big, mature post oak trees all around the property. And really a great house with a really interesting history. But let me start by showing you where we're located. That's the property. That's downtown Fredericksburg. So from Fredericksburg, you head north right about 13 miles. And you take a right on Bell Mountain Road. And then it's the first property on your left. And down at the end of Bell Mountain Road is the Bell Mountain Winery and Vineyard. So really kind of cool to have that just at your back doorstep. So as I was saying, you've got lots of really nice, big, mature post oaks all around. The main house is here. You've got a big lap pool just out back with a little pavilion. And you've got a horse barn with two stalls, hayloft. And it's really great soils for animals. It'd be a great horse property. And you're located right in the Willow City Loop area. So some of the most scenic sites around Fredericksburg, and you can be back in town in, you know, 15 minutes. So let's go in and take a look around. I'm just on the front porch. So as the story goes, this original portion of the house was built in the 1880s and was moved here from Llano in the 1980s by a member of the Neiman Marcus family. And you've got the beautiful wood floors in here, high ceilings, old original fireplace. And just lots of charm in this house. I think I'd use that for the dining room. And you've got a bedroom here, or you could use this more as like an office or a study. It's nice built-in bookshelves, and it's got its own private bath with the walk-in shower. And I love all that beaded board wainscoting around. Then a really tastefully updated kitchen. The kitchen, you have a back porch. You actually have three really nice porches to sit on at this house. But like I was saying, a nicely updated kitchen, but still has a lot of the old charm. I love that island in here. Big farmhouse sink, stainless appliances. And then on this side of the kitchen, you have another access to the outside where the pool is. And we've got what could be used as another bedroom. Or again, I think this could also make a nice little home office area. And this has a half bath, but there's actually plenty of room to put a shower in if you wanted to do an additional full bath. Then you'd have 4 bedrooms, 5 baths. So that's the original old part of the house. Then this was a breezeway that got closed in. And it's heated and cooled, of course. But then they put in this really cool flagstone flooring. Another nice fireplace, masonry. Just a really warm feeling room there. And pay attention to all these doors. I mean, there's just a lot of cool old features in this house with doors and windows. But here you've got a 2-car garage. Nice little sitting area. Have another bedroom. This bedroom overlooks the pool and the field out back. and we'll head out back in a minute. And then this one also has a full bath. This one has the old claw-footed tub, pedestal sink. So back through this second sitting area, and we'll head upstairs to where the master bedroom is. And again, just really awesome touches with like these old doors. So just up the stairs, you have this massive master bedroom, 18 by 20, tile floors in here, lots of windows, lots of light, the vaulted ceilings. This is set up with kind of his and her bathrooms. This one has a full walk-in shower. Kind of an old farmhouse sink in here. And then here you've got another claw-footed tub. And there's also a huge walk-in closet. From the master bedroom, you can also get down to the pool from the deck. There's a little spiral staircase that'll bring you down. But just a really nice little setup. And I love that lap pool. And then there's the barn out from the background. So obviously I've just come back downstairs. I'm off of one of the living areas. Story on the pool, apparently one of the owners had a college athlete who was a swimmer, so they actually put this lap pool in. There's that deck off the master and just kind of the back of the house. Again, lots of beautiful trees back here. Now I've walked over to the barn. Like I said, you've got two horse stalls, you got a big hayloft. Can't say enough about the setting. It's just really pretty out here. So if you've been looking for a historic spot to call home, this one's really hard to beat, especially for the price. Great land, great neighbors. If you'd like more information on it, you can visit my site at www.mikestarks.com. And as always, thanks for watching.